Let's learn how to calculate the chi-square. This is our data. We have a variable here, type of people, staff or student. And here, if they are okay or not okay to use drugs. We have 100 staff and 30% is okay to use drug. We also have 100 students and 50% they are okay to use drugs. These two categorical variables, they are associated because we know that students, they are more likely to use drugs. But suppose that you see this data here. In this case, these two categorical variables are not associated. For both staff and students, they are 40% in favor for using drugs. That means information about the type of the person does help me to predict if they are okay or not okay about using drugs. But how I get these ideal expect numbers? If you sum up 30 and 50, we get 80. That divided by 2 is 40. We do the same here. 70 plus 50 is 120. That divided by 2 is 60. Now, let's calculate the chi-square. This 30 minus 40 comes from here. 30 and 40. And we square the deviation. That's why the name chi-square. And we divide by 40. That comes from here. In the same way, the 70 minus 60, it's coming from here and here. And we divide by 60 here. And this 50 minus 40 is this 50 and this 40. And we divide by 40. You can pause the video and see the intermediate computation. But the result is 8.33. This number is hard to interpret because chi-square can vary from 0 to infinity. That's why we have the Cramer V, that is the chi-square normalized. This n here is the total number of observations, that in this case is 200, because you have 100 students and 100 staff. And this is the minimum between row and column, whatever is smaller. We have 2 rows and 2 columns, and the minimum between 1 and 1, it's 1. Then we do the chi-square that you calculate in the previous slide and divide by 200 and take the square root and you get 0.2. Because of this normalization of the chi-square, the Cramer V varies from 0 to 1. And because 0.2 is closer to 0, this is a case of a weak association. From 0.25 to 75, moderate association. And above 0.75 would be stronger association, and 1 would be perfect association.